a smart plug, but the one I'm going to show today is a Zigbee. And also, why we want to switch to Zigbee and the difference between the Zigbee and a Wi-Fi plug. Let me show that right now. So how we doing, everyone? I'm Dario. This is MediaBoxEnt. Like always, we bring you the latest in technology. It will continue with a series of videos of smart devices such as a Zigbee. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to pair super easy. We're going to be using the Tuya and why we want to switch to Zigbee. Now, if you know how Zigbee works, you are the master of Zigbee and you really have Zigbee working in your home and you want to just go and see the switch, pretty simple. Just right below you see the timeline and you just click and move to the switch. But if not, stay tuned. Okay, so now what is the difference between using a Zigbee device and a Wi-Fi? Well, the first thing is wattage. One of the benefits on the Zigbee device is they use less power. And what is the less power? Okay, so this plug is going to be using about 0.3 to 1 watt. And we're looking at that either a standby or using the switch. Versus 2 to 3 watt in a smart Wi-Fi devices. So now, in a standby Zigbee, let's say it's going to be used about half a watt, 0.5 watts. When they are on, when you turn it on, it's going to use 0.8 watts. Versus a small plug, it's going to be using about 1.5 watts per plug. And when you are on, or mean when you just turn it on, it's going to use 2.5 watts. So it's a big difference. All right, so you see different 2.5 watt versus 1 watt or less than 1 watt for the Zigbee devices. So how much money are we talking about the difference? Not much, but it will add it on after a while. So, and it's more plug, one of these, it will run you about, so if you pay, let's say, 18 cents per kilowatt, so you're going to be paying about, it's not much, but it will add it up, 80 cents a year for one smart plug. Now, versus $2.63 per year on the smart Wi-Fi. Now, if you add it up like 20 of these or 10 of these, you're looking already now at over $20-something. So we'll add it up. So this is one of the benefits. It's going to use less power than Wi-Fi. So that's the number one thing. Another benefit is they are cheaper to get, they are low cost compared to Wi-Fi devices. So you have more devices on the Zigbee than Wi-Fi. Another benefit is we can have like devices like this, a remote control, and now I can control any device at home using a low power remote control that was not available before for Wi-Fi. We can use this. I made a video of this, will be right below on the show you around the top, so check it out. Also, we need another video on thermostat as well, too. Tiny thermostat with one little battery. Now you have 24 hours humidity and temperature control using the Zigbee network. Another benefit is interference. Why? Because Wi-Fi use 2.4 GHz network. Now, the Zigbee devices use a totally different network, so you have less interference compared to the 2.4. Now you see all the difference, right? So we get less cheaper, less interference, and you know, cheaper devices, less power, and allow me to use all these crazy different devices, smart devices I control. It was not available before in Wi-Fi devices. But the other way around, you need to spend money in a gateway, and you need to get a gateway. The gateway I show you today will be right below this video. Now, there are different versions. This version allow me also to control Bluetooth devices, low power, such as smart locks. So if you have a smart lock at home, you can combine now the smart locks, Zigbee devices, and Wi-Fi all in one device. This guy is a Wi-Fi, or you can just go and plug it in right into your router. This one has a voice prompt as well, too. I'll leave you the link. Now, another benefit, and you get on Zigbee, it will create a network between each device. Now, in Wi-Fi, you are limited between the distance between your router and the smart plug or the light bulb. So eventually, after so many feet, we'll no longer get a signal, and then you have to get a repeater or you have to get a booster to be able to control these devices. And in CV networks, it works the other way around now. Why? Because each device will create a mesh. Each device will talk to the next device. So now you can go, let's say, 100 feet, as long as there's one device every so many feet. So each one will create own network so you can extend and you no longer a limit to the distance between your router and your Wi-Fi devices. So now you learn why, what is the difference, right, between both. That's why I've been switching too many devices or many of these things on the CV devices are much better. And plus, there are a lot of cool things we can add into it. All right, so now, how we pair the smart switch? All right, this one is pretty simple, has on and off power. By the way, this one will not measure watts. There are some versions will allow you to measure watts real time as well too, not this one, all right? So as soon as we plug it in, this light will start blinking. It needs to be paired. And if I put the light bulb, it's gonna be turning on and off. Now we have that there. So what I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna go and click the plus and devices. Again, we're gonna be using Tuya, compatible with Alexa, Google, whatever device you want to use, is smart, no problem. It already detected, simple. I'm not locking to the 2.4 gigahertz, or my device don't support 2.4, or because I'm running 5 gigahertz. Click on it, show you got a Chinese name there. We change if we want. Click done. We wait for a second until this thing is finished pair. It's off. Let's turn it on, off. As simple as that, right? So now this little guy is going to use, let's say, half a watt compared like the other ones we're using, either 1.5 or 2 watts. And it's done. At this point now, you can control, turn on and off light bulbs, motors, or whatever you want. Remember to follow the instructions on how many watts you can run on these plugs, right? You don't want to go over what the manufacturer recommends. These are 110 volts. There are some versions that allow you also to get real-time wattage. But for me, I didn't have to. So I want to just turn on and off devices. All right, guys, with this, we complete this video. All that info and all these things I show you today, plus those videos, will be right below this video. I'll see you next time. Bye.